Richmond Effing bites the ball right back down the field, and Shoalbo have a good all-around offense that they scored and went on top 7-6. Raffle Knight here using a different backfield. And we'll have Mike Davis parking out the signals. He turns and he gives off to Dave Desmer. Now he fakes, now he's thrown out here to Chris, and it's overthrown, and he has Chris wide open down at about the 45-yard line of Richmond. I tell you, he does a beautiful job faking, because I thought the ball went inside off tackle. He stopped, raised up, and Chris Desmer went down and outside to the right, and it was wide open. The ball was maybe 2 or 3 yards overthrown, but that would have been a heck of a pickup.
Bob, we mentioned it earlier, and when you talk to the different coaches around, they talk about that one of the things, that's one of the keys to the success of the Castle Knights has been the deceptiveness of their quarterback this year.
Right. This Mike Davis has really blossomed into one of the finest quarterbacks in Southern Indiana. Chris Desmer back to punt at his own 25-yard line. He gets it up. Boy, he just barely got it off. A beautiful kick all the way over the head of the back getting all the way down to the 5-10-yard line. What a job, Larry. How far was that? He was kicking from his own 25. That was about a 71-yard punt. Is that right?
Well, actually, from the line of scrimmage, but it was 39 and 13, which would make it a 62-yard punt.
62-yard. Okay, I almost went two-yard. What a kick, and again, a castle rose as Bart Denning chose to let it go, Larry, and he had room to win it. But he let it go over his head, but rolled all the way down to the 4-yard line. First and 10 for the Richmond Red Devils. John Welsh sets his offense. He has a high formation. He turns and gives to Tim Cornett off right tackle, and Cornett is hit at the line of scrimmage and stopped. He gets nothing whatsoever, so it's going to be a second and 10 for the Richmond Red Devils. 10 minutes and 40 seconds to go in the first half. Richmond Red Devils leading Castle Knights 7-6. We have a beautiful night here for football. We have a fantastic crowd on both sides of the field. We have green zone bleachers in both ends, and we have a good crowd in each end of the field where the portable bleachers have been put up. Here we go, second and 10 for the Richmond Red Devils, and there's a flag down, and the officials blew it dead, so we'll see what we have here. It may be against Castle this time. It looks like maybe they were offside, maybe encroachment, since it was blown dead before the play got off, and we're going to show offside, and they need the castle, and it's going to be a pickup of 5 more, so it's going to make it. They did pick up 1 yard on the first carry, so let's call it second and 4. 10 minutes and 17 seconds to go in a real fine ball game. The only difference right now is the missed extra point by the Castle Knights. Richmond leading 7-6. Okay. Jim Ferrari. Ferrari coming out. The offensive center. Sean Welch sets the team. He's going to play several times. He gives off to Bart Denning off right tackle, and Bart picks up. The only difference right now is a missed extra point by the Castle Knights. Richmond leading 7-6. Okay, Jim Ferrari. Ferrari coming out. The offensive center. Sean Welch sets the team. He's going to play several times. He gives off to Bart Denning off right tackle, and Bart picks up a couple of yards. All the way up to about the 13-yard line, I believe, about the 13-yard line, so it's going to be third and a long run for the Richmond Red Devils. Larry, we just have a fantastic night after having a kind of a grizzly overcast day.
It's really a very nice evening.
Okay, here we go, the Richmond Red Devils. Shift into a close up, and there's a pass out here in the front, and it hits the ground, intended for wide receiver number 22, Randy Gibson. Had Randy had the ball been a little higher, and he could have thought that he was in a position for a first down. But now both teams are going to have to show their punt. Castle Knights with a fantastic 62-yard punt by Chris Grosner, and now back to punt for Richmond is the all-purpose man, Bart Denning. Seems like he does a little bit of everything. 5'10", 170-pound senior. He just barely gets it off. It's coming down fair catch by Kenny Brown at the Richmond 43-yard line. So that time, Larry, on the exchange of punts, Castle picked up about 20, 25 yards.
30-yard cut that time.
Okay, so Castle fans are on their feet, rooting for the Knights to get the offense rolling. They're excellent field position. position at the Richmond 43-yard line, 9:27 to go in the first half. Timmy Brown comes out of the game, and up to the offensive line for the Castle Knights is Pat Luckier, the offensive center. He sets his offensive team. Mike Davis sets in behind the quarterback, I formation, and we have offensive movement by number 66, Dan Thurman, and it's going to cost the Castle Knights 5 yards. A bunch of flags went up in the air, and when they go up, they eventually come down.
And that cost you 2 yards.
Looked like flag, though, that time. We could see the infraction from here.
That one was very obvious. The body moved forward, but the football forgot to move backwards. So the first and 15 this time, back at the 48-yard line, Richmond's own 48.
Nothing wrong with that. Fulmer's just operating out a different snap count than everybody else.
Okay. All right, here we go. First and 15, and we have split wide with Deion Chester to the left, and inside we have the fake, and here comes number 32 around the left end, and he's still moving all the way down to about the 40-yard line, and of course that is number 32, Joe Huff. He does a nice job from the tight end position, and Joe that time came around on the fake, and they use that as a reverse, and he skirted the left end, went down the sideline, and picked up about 11 yards of first field. We'll see where they mark it down here, 5, 10 yards. And so now it's going to be a second and 5 for the Castle Knights. The ball on about the 39-yard line of the Richmond Red Devils. 9:05 to go in the first half. Mike Davis, the fine quarterback, sets his team. Chris Brosmer in motion to the right. Davis gives off straight up the middle. There's a beautiful shot by Neil Chapman. And Chapman is down across the 35 after close to a first down. And Larry, I believe it is a first down. Let's see what the officials say. They're telling him to hold the ball. But I don't think there's any doubt in my mind left over.
They're going to bring out the crew to take a measurement.
Right. Unless the lines are off about a yard, that is going to be a first down.
That's a different excuse. That's why we called about some this year. This is because the yard markers are off, of course. Taking a look at some more of our high school football boosters, Newburgh Business Service and H&R Block Incorporated in Newburgh, the Perrigo Funeral Hall, Newburgh House of Furniture, custom furniture of uncustomary prices, and pizza shop, and the Newburgh Plaza.
Okay, well, you heard the fans right here, Kappa. As you could tell, it was a first down about the length of the football. And so how many first downs is that?
Right now for the Castle Knights is 6.
6 first downs here in the first half. They've done a real nice job with their offense. But so has Richmond, and they're on top 76. Deion Chester is just right to the left. I formation. Chris Brosmer goes in motion, and here's a fake. And now the official, I think the whistle or somebody did, but there's a pass down to Neil Chapman as he broke out of the backfield all the way down to about the 11-yard line. Did I hear a whistle?
I didn't hear.
Okay. Good enough. That must have been with my eardrum. But anyway, that time, Rose, that Mike Davis took the ball inside, and I thought, no way does he have the ball, and all of a sudden Neil Chapman broke down and over the middle and was wide open, and Mike Davis gave him with a beautiful pass all the way down to the 11-yard line. Another first down, number 7.
Right.
Number 7 for the Castle Knights. So with 7 minutes and 58 seconds to go, Castle Knights trying to take the lead again. Our formation. Chris Brosmer in motion to the right. Mike Davis gives off to David Brosmer, and Davis down across the 10. And we'll see where we mark it down, maybe about the 9-yard line. So now it's going to be 2nd and about 7 for the Castle Knights. Is offense down here in the first half, 7.5 minutes to go in the half. Richmond on top, 7-6. What a fantastic night, what a beautiful crowd. And Richmond, team cornerback number 13, calls timeout, and with timeout, we will return.
McMurtry Martin Papers Incorporated in Evansville has been supplying papers for industry, business, institutions, and fine printing papers for 25 years. They have 7 trucks covering the tri-state area daily, Monday through Friday. They do industrial and printing papers. Call McMurtry Martin Incorporated 422-1184 for superb service and quality products. McMurtry Martin Incorporated is located at 27 Pansco Avenue in Evansville. Remember, they've been serving Evansville and the tri-state for 25 years. Their service and products always mean quality.
Supporting the Castle Knights is Colonial Carpets and Floor Covering in Newburgh, serving the whole tri-state area. Check Colonial Carpets first. free delivery, free estimates, free measurements, and guaranteed quality installation at Colonial Carpets. Save now on multicolored, sculptured shag carpet, normally $12.50 a square yard, but right now, only $7.50 a square yard. Save on this beautiful high-low shag carpet at Colonial Carpets, located at Highway 66 and Outer Lincoln in Newburgh. Phone 853-5699.
Okay, we're right back here, 7:26 to go. We have a man in motion, Mike Davis rolls back. He takes, he's going to go around left end. He's got a little running room. He's going across the 8 to about the 8-yard line where he's taken down. Mike Davis that time on the Cougars. Fake off right tackle to Dave Rosemary, kept the ball rolled around the left end. Cut back inside, but a beautiful job of tackling by somebody there from Richmond. Held him to just a minimal gain, let's say a half a yard, and it's going to be a third and long six, short seven, whatever you want to call it for the Castle Knights. 6 minutes and 55 seconds to win the first half. Richmond leading 7-6. Mike Davis, high formation. He turns, he takes, he gives a little kick back over the middle, and it's knocked away. It was intended for number 40, Gary Giles, and it was batted up in the air and almost intercepted right around the goal line.
No, Gillis.
Okay, Gary Gillis, right. Good luck on him. Take a note of that real quick.
6:37 left here in the first half. At the trailing Richmond, 7-6. And into the ball game to attempt the field goal is Matt McDowell. It will be a 25-yard attempt.
And Kenny Brown is the man holding. And the snap is back. The kick is up, and it looks good, though.
It is.
And the referee finally raised his hands as he checks it out of the other official. So with 6:42 to go in the first half, the Castle Knights on the toe of Matt McDowell takes the lead, 9-7. We will return.
See your local AMCO dealer located in Evansville at 1709 North Ferris Avenue. That's Evansville, Old Highway 41 North.
Want to talk to four of the best insurance agents at once? Talk to Jim Fanning, your State Farm agent. Jim Fanning is four of the best agents around because he can be your car insurance agent, your homeowner's agent, and your life and health agent. See Jim Fanning, his office is in the Newburgh Plaza, or give him a call at 853-7071. Jim Fanning in the Newburgh Plaza. Electricity, necessary but dangerous. Don't take chances. When you need electrical work done, any size of job, call L.E. Raley Electric Company of Newburgh, serving our whole area. Raley Electric Company deals in commercial, farm, and residential electrical work. Wiring, rewiring, upgrading service, remodeling, electrical work of all kinds. Raley Electric Company, a licensed and insured contractor. In the yellow pages under electric.
Okay, on the ensuing kickoff, Matt McDowell took the ball down to the 10-yard line where Bart Binning turned it up the middle to the 28-yard line, first and 10 for the Richmond Red Devils. Here's the ball given up to a little back, Corey King off left tackle, and he picks up about 3 or 4 yards, Larry. That's the first time we've seen him this year. We saw a lot of him last year at Richmond. He was only 5'3", 130-pound senior, but he looks like a bowling pin out there.
That's
a bowling ball, one of the
A scoring drive for the Castle Knights, 2 minutes 45 seconds, 43 yards, 7 plays, 2 first down, and a 25-yard field goal by Matt McDowell as it's 9-7 Castle.
So a pickup of 5 yards that time by Corey King. So Sean Rush gets his offense, high formation, he turns, he fakes, he's going to throw, he looks down, over the middle, could be intercepted, no, it's a beautiful reception by number 86, Scott Farrell. That time, right down and over the middle, a beautiful pass from Sean Welsh to number 86, the big tight end, 6-1 Scott Bell, and he picks up the first down all the way down to the Richmond 36-yard line. Oh, that was a real nice job. I thought it might be intercepted because there were three blue jerseys around him, but the pass was perfectly thrown.
I did too, Tom. I thought it looked like it might be able to be intercepted, but the ball was right on the money.
Okay, here we go. Richmond showing again. They're not afraid to move the football in any way they can. Close up formation. Sean pitches out to Corey King, and he's going to be judged up. No, he gets loose. He
turns the corner, and he's going to pick up good yardage, maybe enough for a first down. Larry, at that time, he was in the grasp of number 70 for the Castle Knight, Greg Siebert, but he just got loose. He goes tiny and yet strong. He turned the corner and picked up about, let's say, 8 yards all the way up to the Castle 45-yard line. The football just over the 45-yard line. So now we have a second and about two for the Richmond Red Devils. 5:13 to go in the first half. Castle on top, 9-7. So here we go. Quarterback Sean West brings his offensive team out. Richmond Red Devils shift from the high formation to a pro set. They give off to, there's a fumble, and he picks it back up. Oh, my gosh. I think it was number 13, Tim Cornett. We'll see when he gets up. He went right up the middle. He fumbled the football, and it bounced right back up in the air. He caught it right in stride, Larry. I mean, he didn't break stride one and picked up the first down.
Looked like he was dribbling the basketball.
It sure did, and that was one of the lucky hops, because those don't usually happen. They usually dart away from you when you hit the point of that football. So as a result, they got it right back and got the first down. The ball on the Castle 37-yard line. Here we go. Here's a fake. Here's a pass. He's got a man open again. It's complete all the way down to the 25-yard line. Number 22, Randy Gibson. I tell you what, these receivers have some fantastic hands, though. That time, Randy Gibson broke down and out to the right flat. 5'11", 170-pound senior. Again, I thought the ball was almost going, but he got his body turned around, got his arms up in the air, and just got it out of fingertips, brought it down, and he crossed the 15 down to about the 13-yard line. So, another first down with 4:27 and the clock running in the first half. Castle leading 9-7. Sean West, 53, my formation, wide receiver to the right. He turns, he pitches back to Corey King, his little back, and he's going to be stopped behind the line of scrimmage and knocked out of bounds at about the 11-yard line. That time, Corey King on the pitch back from Sean West, the quarterback, tried to shoot the right end, which was a short side of field, and he did not pick up any yardage. In fact, he lost two, so it's going to be second and 12. Liz, what do you think?
I don't know. Richmond's going to the air when they need the big yardage, and they're going to need something right here out of second at 11 with 3:50 left here on the first half.
So, Richmond showing why they're 9-1 on the year, losing only to Lafayette Jets. Close up formation. He's going to pass. He's got a man after him. And, that was awful close to pass interference there. Awful close. Bart Benning was the intended receiver, but evidently number 62, Rodney Russell for Castle. From where we were, it looked like he was laying on his back, but evidently it was after the pass got to the intended receiver out of his grasp. And it was not pass interference.
The official was right there running stride for stride, but it sure looked like he was on his back early.
They have one in front of him, one behind him. If we use more officials here than any other game, you have five officials used in the playoffs. Okay, here we go. And we have a 3rd and 12. Sean Nelson bucking out the signals. I formation. Two wide receivers. He rolls back. He's going to pass. He's looking over the middle. He's got a man open. Knocked down. A beautiful job. Beautiful job, Larry. That was touchdown to number 85, Lloyd Spicer. I thought it was her, and Dave Grosner broke in front, got the hand, and drove the football down to the ground. That was heated.
That was a quick-fired defensive effort that time.
That's right, and that's why Castle is so strong. They don't allow these little things to happen. So now, number 11, Dane Gibson, to try to put Richmond back on top. And from what I understand, he can kick him from the 35, 30-yard line, and he's going to be kicking this one to a 22, make it a 32-yard kick. The ball is up. It looks like it's long enough, but it is wide to the left, and the score remains Castle 9, Richmond 7, 3:26 to go in the first half. We will be back.
Another group of our tournament boosters dropped into bag action your way. Joyce's Hair Design in the middle of Traveler, the Baker's Rack, and the Newburgh Plaza, Greenville, and in Rockford. The hair plays on Washington Street and Newburgh, and Jeannie's Closet Resale and Consignment next to Frenchies and Newburgh.
Okay, right back here, we have quarterback by Mike Favor turning and giving the ball off to Chris Grosner as he scoops left tackle and picks up good yardage up across the
25 to about the 27-yard line to pick up that time of close to 7 yards, and we're going to call it 7, and make it a second and 3. So a big break for the Catholic Knights, though, as that ball was pretty long. A very good kick by number 11, Dane Gibson, but it was wide about a yard to the left, kicking to the south end field goal post. Okay, 9-7, Castle still on top. Time running out in the first half. Here's a pitch back to Chris Pilsner, and he was up to about the line of scrimmage as he tries to skirt the left end, but a beautiful tackle that time by number 58, Bruce Sams, 5'9", 166-pound senior linebacker for Richmond, and he held Chris that time to no gain, so we still have a 3rd and 3, the ball resting at the 27-yard line of Castle, and 2:30 to go in the first half. No, we have really seen a fine football game here, and anybody that wants to come in, I'm sure they're selling tickets yet, and you're going to see one heck of a halftime program and also the rest of this football game. Here's a draw up the middle, and Chris Bozeman does a beautiful job picking his way up through the middle, dancing left, dancing right, getting up to the 35-yard line where we have another first down. And how many is that, Larry?
That is now 8 in the ball game for the Castle Knights, and of those, the 5 have been rushing and 3 have been passing.
So, the ball now resting just the nose of it over the 35-yard line of Castle. They have 65 yards to go for a touchdown, and they are on top here with 2 minutes even to go in the first half, 9-7 over the Richmond Red Devils. Mike Davis brings his offensive team out I formation, both ends in tight. He barks out the signals, he rolls back, he fakes, he's going to throw, he's looking long, he's still looking long, oh, that could be out of bounds. That time he has Deion Chester long down at about the Richmond 30-yard line, but he chose to throw the ball out of bounds. I don't know that time for two defenders for Richmond, Larry, but it looked like Deion might have been able to break deep, and but we don't know for sure. So here we go with the second and 10 for the Castle Knights. And what do we have here? They call a penalty, Larry.
Got a penalty on the play. I didn't see the flag, Dallas. Yeah, I still don't see where it's at. It's right. Unless the guy had picked it up. Got to get a holding.
Well, they're talking to Castle, so it's going to be, if it's holding, it's going to be 15 yards. And here goes 5, here goes 10, here goes 15. The ball's going to rest just over midfield. Richmond territory, we're going to call it the 49-yard line of Richmond, a first down on a holding penalty, and that puts the Castle Knights with 1:43 to go in the half in beautiful shape to get down close for either another score on the ground, in the air, or by the toe of Matt McDowell. Okay, Mike Davis has Deion Chester, Roger the right, I formation. He barks out the signals, he takes the snap, he rolls back, he fakes, he throws out in the right flat to Deion Chester, and it's complete, and he is hit down at about the 40-yard line, and it is going to be awful close, a little bit short of the first down.
And I tell you, Tom, he really got hit from the behind side, and the Richmond defender who made the hit is down now, that's Ricky Robinson.
Okay, Ricky Robinson that time, and he is down, as he came up, like you said, and really drilled Deion Chester from behind, but maybe he got the worst end of the deal.
I was surprised to see Chester able to hang on to the ball. It's going to make it a second and one situation.
You're absolutely right. I thought the way he got drilled it right in the back, that ball would pop up in the air, but he held on to it. So we'll have a second and inches for the Castle Knights, probably length of the football, with 1:22 to go in the first half, Castle leading 97. Our formation, Mike Davis rolls back. He fakes again. He's going to throw. He's still, he's going to run the ball now. He's heading out of bounds for a first down down around the 35-yard line, maybe the 34 of Richmond. That time, Mike Davis fakes once. He fakes twice. Then he pumps long and decided to run the ball himself. He ran it out of bounds with 1:10 to go in the first half, and now they are down just across the 35-yard line. Larry,
that for the Castle Knights is now 9 first downs, and I'm telling you, Tom, things are really even. The score, 9-7 Castle. The first downs are now 9-7 in favor of the Castle Knights. Richmond has gained 143 yards. The Castle Knights now about just a little bit shy of 160 yards.
Okay, Mike Davis, there's only a little field pickup. Oh, what a catch that time. Number 32 for the Castle Knights, and that is so hot. This 175-pound junior popped the ball on his fingertips. Larry, he was wrapped down around the 15-yard line, and he held onto the ball, went down, still held onto the ball, and was finally stopped at the 12-yard line?
Right.
So it's going to be another first down for the Castle Knights at the 12. 55 seconds clock running in the first half. Castle leading 9-7. Mike Davis starts out the signal. He turns. He fakes. He still fakes. Now he's looking. Here's a pass out. There he goes. Off the fingertip to Deion Chester. He was deflected by number 10, Bart Denning, who's all over this football field for Richmond. And down on his knees was Deion Chester, though. And the ball went off his fingertip after it was tipped by Bart Denning. What a play. I tell you, this just got a football game, and what an exciting way to show these people what Indiana football is all about.
33 seconds left here in the first half. Castle 9, Richmond 7, 2nd and 10 for the 12 for the Castle Boys.
So, wide receiver, Deion Chester, wide left, Mike Davis, eye formation. He turns, he fakes. He fakes again. He's looking. He's got Neil Chapman open, and he's, oh, it's a fumble! And it's going to be down. It's still alive, and Castle's still after it. It's out of bounds, and Castle will get the ball at the 1-yard line. And Neil Chapman got Gil Ney, and there's two players down. One from Richmond still laying there. Chapman got popped, and the ball laid there. Larry got knocked back past Chapman within an inch of him. He could not recover if he was out flat to get the ball. We have coaches out on the field from both sides of the field. We have photographers down there. We have officials trying to figure out, but the ball rolled out of bounds at the 1-yard line. And if I read my football right, the ball will be Castle's because nobody recovered it in between the time it was fumbled. It'll be Castle's ball at the 1-yard line, 31 seconds to go in the first half.
And that'll set up a first and goal from the 1. And Kenny Brown slowly getting back up now. Now we're out of the flag.
Right. Unless they call him for intentionally kicking the ball or something. No. Flag down. I think that's an inadvertent flag.
I think it's fallen out of the official pocket. Yeah, there he's finally picked it up. He didn't realize it.
Well, they're calling two penalties there. Did you see that, Larry?
No, they didn't call a penalty at him.
Well, they motioned two. I had to check on that at halftime. I thought he motioned a personal foul, but maybe he's not.
Okay.
Here we go. With 31 seconds to go in the first half. And we're at fans of home down alongside the field. 1-yard line for the Castle Knights. Mike Davis starts out the signal. Eye formation. He turns. He gives out to Chris Bozeman. And he is in for the touchdown. 28 seconds to go in the first half. The Castle Knights are front on top. 15-7. 28 seconds to go in the first half. And Chris Bozeman that time went off. Left tackle in for the touchdown. And for Chris, that is touchdown number 8 this year. And he is a fine junior who will be back again next year for the Castle Knights. So, Larry, that drive here in a minute. We'll be able to tell him about it. And we'll have Matt McDowell out, ready to take a shot at the extra point. Kenny Brown is out there as a holder again, 15-7. Castle on top. And here's the snap. Kenny Brown sets it down. There's the feet. It looks long. It's over the bleachers. And the arms go up. And it is good. The score. The 28 seconds to go in the first half. Castle leads Richmond 16-7 here at Paradise. And we will be back.
It's almost sure to come up every time you get together with other homemakers is the high cost of living. And no wonder, because living costs concern you and food costs are of extreme importance to you. But there's one sure way to cut down on those high costs, and that's by shopping for all foods at McCain's Key Market in Chandler, where lower prices are in effect day in and day out. McCain's Key Market knows the foods you want, they know your favorites, as well as the high qualities you demand, and they supply those foods in an amazing variety, all savings priced to help your budget stay in good balance. All over town, families are sitting down three times a day to meals that are entirely prepared with foods purchased at McCain's Key Market. There's plenty of reason for shopping at McCain's Key Market. Quality that's outstanding and prices that are economical are an everyday occurrence at McCain's Key Market in Chandler.
Okay, here we are. Matt McGraw kicks the ball down to the 1-yard line. Corey Keene comes up the middle and returns it up over the 20 to about the 22-yard line. And Larry, on that penalty a while ago at the 1-yard line, that was right. They did call a penalty, but they charged it against Richmond for batting the ball out of bounds. But really, from where we were a lot further away than the official that called it. It looked like they were all going for it, and the thing got kicked out of bounds. And since the other team had not recovered it and had possession, it belonged to the offensive team of Wisconsin. So, they wasn't going to be any difference anyway. They'd have the ball at the one, so maybe they got the half-yard line.
Richmond has called timeout now with 19 seconds left in the half. We'll remind you that following our initial halftime break, we will be going to the Willie County Courthouse for election night coverage, about a 2 or 3 minute summary, as we see what returns have available from the Willie County Courthouse. And Norman Huff will be handling all of our election coverage for 1982 live from the Willie County Courthouse. Another group of our tournament boosters helping to bring action your way, go get them tackle, sir. Mitchell Kitchen Center on Highway 261 in Newburgh. Chandler Hardware, two blocks south of Highway 62 on Illinois Street. Brady Insurance, your independent insurance agent, and G&M Services Restaurant Service Company in Newburgh. Just a few of the many tournament boosters helping to bring action your way here on WBBL-FM in Boonville. Castle 16, Richmond 7, 19 seconds left to end the first half of action.
So we have had just a fantastic game, though. It kind of goes in with this foul. It's been a beautiful foul. Went over to Midway and Spencer County to my father-in-law's house today. For SIAC over at Midway, and you just look at the trees there and everything so beautiful. You hate to see fire in. Some of these trees look like they have big golden apples hanging on, just so pretty with the leaves, golden yellow. So here we go, 19 seconds to go. The officials are waiting, and now the referee, Joseph Whistle, quarterback Sean West, barks out the signal. Our formation, and we have two wide receivers to the right. He waves back. Of course, he's going to pass. Now he's hit and dug down at about the 15-yard line. And in on the tackle for the Castle Knights was number 79, Big Mike Hogue. But as I said before, he was one heck of a wrestler. I look for him to do a state final this year. 5'11", 200-pound senior. In on the tackle. And there is the end of the first half as Richmond lets the clock run out low. We have seen some beautiful football. Now we get to watch the band. If anybody's close low, they ought to get out here to see the football game. We still got a good one left. Good. The score, Castle 16, Richmond 7 here. Paradise Larry is going to finish up here.
Okay, we do want to remind everybody that immediately following these messages, we'll have a report from the Warren County Courthouse of this year's election results. Again, it is halftime, Castle 16 and Richmond 7.
Easy to drop off and pick up the dry cleaning. They're open 7 to 5:30 Monday through Friday, 7:30 to 5 on Saturday. Depend on Chandler Cleaners. They're the pros to handle your clothes.
Right back here at Castle High School with the score, Castle 16, Richmond 7, as the Castle Knights have returned back out onto the field. Taking a look at the first half statistics, the Castle Knights have outgained the Richmond Red Devils 220 to 130
miles east of the 261 junction near Newburgh, features quality NAPA brand replacement cars for both domestic and foreign-built cars and
farm
equipment. Keep in mind, the Warwick Automotive Supply is the do-it-yourselfer's best friend. Open Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 8 to 5, Warwick Automotive Supply on State Road 66, 1 mile east of the 261 junction near Newburgh.
This way, if you're the number 2 caller, number 3 or number 7, nobody cares how you compare to number 29, right? So they've done challenges and taste tests and comparisons against Coca-Cola, and maybe that's why Coke is called a little thing. It's got real refreshment, a real big taste. If you're number 2 or number 3 or number 7 or number 29, you know what you're going to be when you grow up. Yes, Coke is it.
Kickoff in the first half. Matt McGrath kicked the ball all the way down to the 3 yards deep into the end zone where Bart Benning caught the kickoff, and it was blown good by the officials, brought out to the 20-yard line. And so we have the first play from the line of scrimmage, and it's a pickup by Tim Cornett, who finds the fullback of 1 yard to the 21-yard line. So we have a second and 9. The second half just starting, with the Castle Knights on top here at Paradise over Richmond 16-7. Sean West, all formation, wide receiver to the left and to the right. He rolls back. He's going to close. Now he goes up the middle. He's going to break it for a nice run. And he's up over the 30 to the 35-yard line. More than enough for a first down. The officials blew it good. A pickup of about 13 yards. The guy resting at the 35 would have been first and 10 for the Richmond Red Devils.
Well, he turned that into a first down, staring in the eye of disaster there momentarily.
You're exactly right, Larry. That's what I was going to say. It looked like he was going to be encompassed by the pocket. He took one step up like a good quarterback does. He saw some running room. He tucked the ball under his arm and took off. Okay, here we go. First and 10, the ball resting right on the 55-yard line. Richmond's own 35. And here's a pitch back to Corey King. A little scooter senior turns back inside, and he's got good running room, and he's up to the 45, and just a little bit short of the first down. Corey King, number 23, and Larry, again, let's give the fans his statistics, 5'3", and that's right, 5'3", he's a star, 130-pound senior, and when he darts, he's tough to take down a pickup of 9.
And you saw he runs under the defense. That's a literal problem.
Hey, right, if they tackle high, they're in trouble. Second down and about a foot for Richmond. The ball resting directly on the 45-yard line. Sean West goes off to Bart Ginning, and he's got enough for a first down off right tackle. A pickup up to about the 47-yard line. Richmond's own 47, so with 10-10 to go in third quarter. Castle leading 16-7. Another first down for Richmond Red Devils. They are for real, Larry, and they're going to be a tough one here as the game goes along. Okay, here's an offensive center, James Zorowski, coming out, number 52-17. Sean West barks out the signals. Eye formation, he rolls back, he's going to throw again. He throws out the right flat, and it's going to be good. No! I thought it was caught, but it must have bounced in. Intended for wide receiver number 22, Randy Gibson. Larry, from here, I thought the ball was high enough, but evidently it must have bounced or was dropped.
Well, it was right in front of the coaching staff for Richmond, and nobody squawked a bit over there, so I do feel it must have, as you said, it either was grabbed on one hop or he dropped it after he went down or didn't have possession of it.
Right, he went out in the right flat, just turned a little button hook pattern, turned right around. The ball was right down at his knees. He went down for it on his knees and would have been an awful close to a first down. But here we go, second turn, eye formation, wide receivers from both sides of the field. And Sean West rolls back, and he's going close, and he's going to be dragged down for about a 10-yard loss. And of course, that's number 32, Joe Huff, coming in from his defensive end position that time. Joe Huff, and he is 6'1", 175-pound junior, and what a job he did, Larry.
He really tackled him.
Yes, he did. Sean West rolled back that time. Just as soon as he turned around, he just had enough time to tuck it and try to keep his ribs from getting back. And that's exactly what he did, is he lost a good 10 yards all the way back to about the 36-yard line. So now we have a third and 21 in another passing situation. Eye formation, two wide receivers, one to each side of the field. West bounced out the signals. He rolls back. There's a little draw up the middle of Corey, and he's not going to pick up for a yard or two as he came tackled by half of the defensive line. The Castle Knights have picked up at maybe 2 or 3 yards, but anyway, it's going to be too far for a shot at the first down, so set up a punting situation. Okay, the ball resting just a little bit, let's say the 36-yard line.
You could hear the fans that time. DJ made the stop, and they were all hollering out the Deuce, Deuce out here.
Right, heck of a senior. Okay, back to punt. We have number 10, Bart Denning. He gets off a low one. And it hits at the 37, rolls down, picked up at the, by Kenny Brown. He takes the right in at the 30 and gets back up to about the 45-yard line. Kenny Brown doing a nice job, Larry, as that ball hit. And Larry, he picked it off his shoe top at the 30 and came back up, and it was driven out of bounds at the 45-yard line. Castle's on 45.
34-yard punt that time.
Okay. That gives Castle good field position again as they take over at their own. The ball's resting over the 45. We're going to call it the 46-yard line, Larry. First and 10, 8:19 to go in the third quarter. Castle on top of Richmond, 16-7. And we have Mike Davis backing out the signals. He gets the ball off to the second man here, and that is David Grossman. as he takes inside to Neil Chapman, gave out to Grossman. Grossman left about a yard back to the 35-yard line. Nice job by the defense that time of Richmond, and they have a big one over there, number 76, John Brown, a 6'5", 270-pound dropping ball. How would you like to have somebody like that coming back for 2 years and make a mean?
That's true.
How would you like to have him come up in your supper table?
Forget it.
That's right. Formation. Mike Davis gives off inside to Neil Chapman, and he's not going to pick up much. He fights his way to the original line of scrimmage, maybe a little bit beyond it. Yes, we're going to call it a pickup of three, setting up a third and eighth, a barrel wrestling at the 37-yard line. So, Chapman trying to keep the ball inside to eat up the clock and also to force Richmond inside and tight, and that's what they're doing. So we have a third and eighth. Ball rushing at the 37. I formation. Mike Davis starts out the signal. He rolls past. He takes his hand off. He's going to pass. He throws downfield, and it's behind him. And intended receiver that time. We have Craig Bowe going down, and the ball was thrown behind him. And when he tried to stop, his feet went out from underneath him, and the pass fell incomplete. And we do have a flag down low. So we'll see what it is.
And they're talking to Richmond.
It looks like we have, a holding penalty against the Castle Knights. If they take the penalty, it's going to be third and about 18. If they decline it, it will be fourth down in the punting situation. So that's going to be up to them.
Coach Ken Jordan on the far side is going to decline it.
Yeah.
Third in the hands, we're two in the woods.
That's right, exactly. So I think they're going to let it go and let's set up a fourth and eight. They're still talking to Captain Tim Cornett.
Now he's indicating they'll take the penalty.
Yes, they are. They're going to set up a third and about 17, I believe. We'll see where they mark it down here.
This could backfire on them.
Yes, it could. Third and about 22. Third and 22. So the 7:05 will go here in the third quarter. Castle on top, 16-7. And now they're in a tough third and 22-yard pickup needed for a first down. So here they come. And they set in an I formation. Pat Lockyer sets his offensive line. Mike Davis rolls fast. He takes the draw. He takes the pump. He throws long, and he's got Kenny Brown long, but it's going to be intercepted by Bart Denning. He picks it up at the 30. He's back up over midfield, and he's down to the 45-yard line of Castle. A beautiful job that time. Bart Denning went back as a safety and just played center field, and he picked the ball up right in front of the intended receiver, Deion Chester, at the 30-yard line. They turned it all the way back to the Castle 44-yard line. First and 10 for the Richmond Red Devils. And boy, they're showing a lot of class here. They're a fine football team.
Indeed they are. And the ball just a little bit underthrown that time.
Richmond's only loss this year was the Lafayette Jets, the number one ranked team undefeated in the state of Indiana. So Sean Welsh rolls back. He rolls clean pass over the middle, and it's incomplete. Oh, there were four men coming in on Sean Nelson. When you know that happens, though, when you see it, you know it's a screen pass, and the pass was underthrown, but there was a Castle defender there. So that sets up a second down and 10, but still an excellent field position for Richmond. The ball resting at the 44-yard line of Castle. The clock says 6:45 to go in the third quarter. The score here at Paradise on a beautiful evening with the flag blowing gently in the breeze is Castle 16, Richmond 7. Sean Welsh rolls back. He's going to throw. He's just hit, and the ball is wobbling to the ground as he got killed. And in there was number 67, Rick Van Heath. 6 foot, 210-pound senior, and did he ever drill Sean Welsh? And the ball went like a dying quail, though. It just went slobber, slobber, slobber.
You would
do a slobber?
No, that's just what I was going to ask you. But you would have gone that way, too, if you would have been hit like that.
I'd have gone slobber, slobber, slobber down to my knees, real quick. That ran only 5 seconds off the clock for that. 6:40 to go here in the third quarter. 3rd and 10, still good field position for Richmond. Sean Welsh brings out his team. There's one back, two wide receivers to the right, one wide receiver to the left. Yes, he's going to pass. He's going to get hit by Churchill, and he's going to be dragged down all the way back to the back of 35-yard line, the 34-yard line of Castle. And Joe Huff was the man in there. Joe Huff.
There's a man in on the track where his team is killing from the defensive end position, and he did a heck of a job. Nobody picked him up, Larry, and he drilled the quarterback in the back again. Bart, Sean Welsh has taken a beating tonight here in the second half as the Catholic defense is slipping, and now we have a fourth and about 22 yards, and we have a punt, and the punt is from number 10, Bart Denning, and rolls down at about the 32-yard line, and is dead there. So the Castle Knights will take over at the 32-yard line, 5:55 to go in the third quarter, Castle leading 16-7. Larry?
Another group of our tournament boosters joins his hair design in the middle of Chandler, the Baker Track, and the Newburgh Plaza, and Boonville, and in Rockwood. The hair play from Washington Street and Newburgh, and Jeannie's Closet Resale and Consignment next to Frenchie's and Newburgh.
Larry, that was a good example of how the Castle defense can stiffen up, because they really have a basketball. First down, the 44, and they didn't give an inch. Okay, here we have number 40 in motion. Here's a pick back to Chris Gilsmo around right in, and guys Ward picked up 4 or 5 yards. That time, Gillis was in motion, and the pitch went back to Chris Gilsmo. Gillis led the blocking, and Chris picked up a good 5 yards up to the 39-yard line. So now we have a second and 5:11, the clock running in the third quarter. Castle on top, 16-7 overall. Very fine 9-1 Richmond Red Devil football team. So Mike Davis gives off to Chris Gilsmo again, and he's here with the line of scrimmage, and there is a flag down, and
that was right up around the line of scrimmage.
Yes, and beyond the line of scrimmage, we might have had a quick there, a holding or something like that. I would say it's probably against holding, against Castle. These penalties are beginning to hurt.
That's the second 15-yarder of the second half against Castle, and both of them on hold.
That's going to move it back to somewhere around the 20-yard line. We'll see where we mark it off to. 4:56 to go here in the third quarter. The Castle's going in the wrong direction.
That's 45 yards in penalties now against the Castle Knights to 20 for the Richmond Red Devils.
Okay, official. Mark it off, 5, 10, 15, all the way back to the 24-yard line. So now we have a second and about 18, I'm going to call it, maybe 19. We'll see what. Well, I'm going to say 19. Second and 19. And I believe I'm right. We'll take a shot at it. We're 4:54 to go here in the third quarter. Castle leading to 16-7. Mike Davis throws back and he throws one over throws. Oh, almost picked off. Number 10, Bart Denning was there again, and he tipped the ball up in the air. And number 82, who was Vince Vogelsong, 5'11", 158-pound junior defensive back, had it right in his hand to the back of Castle, 45-yard line, and dropped it. That was quite a break for the Castle Knights. And those types of things, to win these championship games, though, you have to capitalize on. That Bart Denning was all over this field. I think he can play with anybody in the state of Indiana.
That's for sure, Tom. He is a great athlete.
Okay, and he plays free safety. Here we go with a give straight up the middle. And a shot. Gillis on a beautiful run up the middle. And he picks up Gillis right up to about the 38-yard line. A nice give that time on inside reverse to Jerry Gillis, and he picked up good yardage, but not enough for a first down. So now we're going to have fourth and about six, with the clock running at 4 minutes and 24 seconds to go in the third quarter. Back deep for the Richmond Red Devils is none other than Bart Denning, and number 30, Chris Grosner, will be attending for the Castle Knights. Clock running down towards 4 minutes to go in the third quarter. And Chris Grosner gets the ball way up in the air, and he hits down at the 30 and goes out of bounds at about the 25-yard line. A nice job that time, getting the ball out of bounds to where Denning can get to it.
That is so.
Then he returned up to a
34-yard punt.
Okay, but not too bad, Larry, because it kept the ball away from an offensive threat and Bart Denning. Okay, 4 minutes and 2 seconds to go here in the third quarter. Castle leading 16-7, and now they have to set their defense and dig in again, but this time in a lot better field position at the Richmond 25-yard line. So offensive center in the 52, Jim Sorrell, comes out.
He's really been battling that.
Yeah, we'll get that name. Okay, he'll give up the middle. The back inning, and he picked up two or three tough yards off left tackle. And we'll see where they mark it down. Up around the 33-yard line. What a pick up. Fellow to pick up the three, making a second, and a back seven. 3 minutes and 44 seconds to go in the third quarter. And here we go. Sean West brings his team out again. High formation. First, the singles wide from both sides of the field. Here's a quick little lookout to number 89, and he picked up 6 yards. Not enough for a first down, but that's number 89, David Rose. And Lowe, David is 6'7", 225-pound junior. Richmond's just a good boy coming back next year.
What did they do, Don?
Juniors, and you throw in that 6'5", 270-pound sophomore coming back, and they also have a 6'5", 260-pound junior coming back. They're going to be back in this playoff again next year. Okay, to pick up that time of about 4 yards, making it third and three. The ball resting at the 33-yard line. Richmond quarterback Sean Welsh hit his man out here in the front, and that's their first down. Number 22, Randy Gibson, was hit up at about the 37, 38-yard line, and that's going to be enough for a first down there. I don't think you hear that. Why? They're making it. First down, the referee said. And the ball resting, we're going to call it the 38-yard line. It's really right in between the 37, 38-yard line. We'll call it the 38. So it's now a first and 10. How many first downs, Ray, for Richmond?
That is now 10 on the ball game.
10 first downs for Richmond Red Devils shows you that they do have solid offense. Okay, here we go. 2 minutes and 20 seconds to go in the third quarter. Sean West, way back. He's going to pass again. He throws over the middle, and it's going to be intercepted. And it is. Number 63, Paul Coffey, the offensive center who plays linebacker on defense. 6 foot, 190-pound senior, picked it up. And Larry, he picked that off the top of the blue ramp or mud, whatever you want to call out there, because it is kind of buried in the middle of the field, but a beautiful job at 2:14 to go on the third quarter. An interception by number 63, Pat Lockyer, a fine senior, who goes both ways. Okay, first and 10 for the Castle Myers. And the same man that picked the ball out, number 63, Pat Lockyer, sets his offense. High formation, Mike Davis picks his out to the left side, and Chris Grosmer is down for a couple of tough yards, maybe three, down across the 45 to about the 43-yard line of Richmond. There's a pickup of 3 yards on the play, setting up a second and seven. 1:35 to go in the third quarter. Castle on top of Richmond Red Devils, 16-7. What a fantastic evening we have here. The flag just blowing gently in the breeze. A nice evening for the fans. Okay, Mike Davis, 63, my formation. He first, he gets the second man. Sure, and there's a special right in. He's got good running room. It's still half. He's down the right sideline. All the way, still out of bounds at about the 23-yard line. Enough, well, more than enough for a first down. All the way down to the Richmond 20. They're trying to mark it at the 24-yard line. So a nice pickup, Larry. How much was that time?
Let's see. From the 36 down to the 23, so that would make it about a 23-yard pickup.
23-yard pickup that time. Quarterback Mike Davis did a beautiful job of taking twice inside, and then he goes to Joe Huff. He came from the in position and did a nice job on the end of the end. Okay, Mike Davis throws back. He goes to Chris Grosmer on the draft. Chris has got running room, and he's all the way down to the 15, down to about the 10, and there's a flag, another flag, and I think it's going to be a penalty. There's a Castle Knights are jumping up and down.
They got a late hit.
A late hit, okay, and the fans are clapping, so you know it's going to be a penalty against Richmond, and I tell you what, Larry, if they take it in here, the ball game's going to be over, and it is a face mask. Thanks for catching that for me, and that's going to take the ball down to about the 6-yard line. We'll see where we mark it. I see it's going to be another first down, and with 1:02 to go in the third quarter, unless Castle makes some kind of mistake here, they're going to take it in, and if they do, it's going to be awful tough for Richmond to come back. They're setting the ball at the 6-yard line. First and goal to go from the 6. We have 1:02 to go in the third quarter. 16-7, Castle on top of the Richmond Red Devils.
Okay, referee checking all the officials. The officials moving the Castle Knight players and the coaches back at least 2 yards behind the out of bounds line. So the clock now running 1 minute to go in the third quarter. Eye formation. Mike Davis strike out signals and there is movement and there is penalty. And it is number, let me catch it here, I believe it was number 79. Let me see if it was. I'm looking at number 79 for the Castle Knights. And of course, that was Mike Hope. Mike leaned forward just enough, and everybody on the Richmond team pointed to him. And the official took his flag, took it, he's going to be 5 yards. And now, as I said, Larry, unless they make mistakes, and that's one of them, they're going to get in here and blow this game wide open. But that's a mistake. And now they're going to have to prove themselves. First and goal to go from the 11 yard line. The clock is running 60 seconds to go in the third quarter. High formation, wide receiver to left, Mike Davis. Starts out the signal. He pitches back to Davis. Chris Posner takes the right in and he goes down to about the 7 yard line. A nice tackle that time by number 87 for Richmond, and that was John Short. John is 5'11, 165 pound junior, and the ball is all the way down to the 7. So we have an injured player on the far side of the field, and it looks like number 72 is injured, and that is Abel Bryant. He is 6'2, 198 pound senior. Larry, the ball is resting at the 7 yard line where Castle has a second and goal to go from the 7.
Tom, another aspect to be taken under consideration, the clock running down all the while. 37 seconds left in the third quarter of action. Another group of our Tedderbooskies go get him, Castle Knights from Mitchell Kitchen Center, Highway 261 north of Newburgh. Chandler Hardberg, 2 blocks south of Highway 62 on Illinois Street. Brady Insurance, your independent insurance agent, and G&M Services Western Service Company in Newburgh.
Okay, everybody boosted the Castle Knights, and glad to do their part in backing the team towards the state playoffs, and the ultimate goal for everybody in the state of Indiana, state championship, regular game division, difference if you're Division A, Double A, or Triple A, you still want to win that championship. So that's what everybody shoots for, and that's what these two fine teams are doing here tonight. Richmond, Red Rebels 9-1 on the season, losing only to number one ranked Lafayette Jeff, 38-14. Castle 10-0 on the season. And Larry, Castle has not given up more than 7 points in any game all year. And it looked like they were going to give up more than that, and they may yet. But when Richmond took their first drive, their second drive of the game, and right down the field and scored, you thought for sure they were going to score again.
And more importantly, they've only given up 7 second half points.
That's exactly right. Okay, our formation, wide receiver to the right, Mike Davis sparks out the signal. He turns, he takes again. He's looking for a receiver. He throws it too low, incomplete to David Brazler in the end zone. It would have been about 5 yards. He's into the end zone for a touchdown, but he stole the ball along the ground, and so now it's going to set up a third and 7 for the Castle Knights. With 19 seconds to go, the clock dead here in the third quarter, Castle leading 16-7.
And I don't think, Tom, I don't think there'll be any hesitation at all by Coach John Lottie. If they don't get it on here, they'll go for it on fourth down.
Okay, Joe Huff, number 32, comes into the game, bringing in a play from Coach John Lottie or Coach Jerry Finn. High formation, wide receiver to left, Mike Silver starts out the signal. Here's Huff on the end around. He's not going to make it. He's going to get hit down at about the 7, maybe a loss, in fact, to the 9 yard line. That time they tried to run the same play. They've been very successful for them. One of them had set up this drive, but it lost yardage that time, and I believe they set it down low at the 9 yard line. We're going to call it fourth and 9, and that's the end of the third quarter. With the score here at Paradise, Castle 16, Richmond 7, we shall return.
Searching for the best deal on new car financing? Look us up, because our auto loan rate has gone down. United Bank National Bank has lowered its auto loan rate to 13.75% for 36-month financing. All you need to qualify, in addition to an approved credit application, is a wallet check in your savings account. Or open a new account today with $100 or more. 13.75% financing available through November 30th, 1982. United National Bank, member FDIC.
McMurtry Marking Papers Incorporated in Evansville has been supplying papers for industry, business, institutions, and fine printing papers for 25 years. They have 7 trucks covering the tri-state area daily, Monday through Friday. They do industrial and printing papers, Call McMurtry Martin Incorporated 422-1184 for superb service and quality products. McMurtry Martin Incorporated is located at 27 Pasco Avenue in Evansville. Remember, they've been serving Evansville and the Tri-State for 25 years. Their service and products always mean quality.
Okay, here we go. Matt McDowell, Kenny Brown will do the holding. The kick is going to be from the 16-yard line. He'll do a kick of 26 yards. We're 12 minutes showing in the fourth quarter. Castle leading 16-7. The snap is back. The kick is up, and it's going to be wide to the right, low. And I will say one thing here. That could be the difference in keeping Richmond in the ballgame. I said they had the ball on the 7-yard line. It's going to be hard to keep track of that, but if they... If Castle made mistakes or kept themselves from scoring, they could keep Richmond in the ballgame, and that's exactly what's happened because they've come out without anything on the scoreboard, and now Richmond has the ball on their own 20-yard line, 11:55 to go in the game, and they're showing some stubbornness too. They're a fine football team.
That's for sure, Don.
Okay, first and 10, Sean Welsh brings his team out. That's the I formation, two wide receivers. He rolls to the left. He's going to keep the ball. He tries to pitch, but he can't, and he's wrapped up after a pickup that's maybe 1 yard at the most. We'll see where they mark it down. That time he scored the left end. He ran the option play right at the last second. He tried to pitch, and it looked like they wrapped up his arms, and he was tackled nicely. But he did pick up a couple of yards up to about the 22-yard line. We're going to call it second and 8. 11 and a half minutes to go in the ballgame. Castle on top, 16-7, and Richmond on the move offensively. John Welch bucks out the signal. He rolls back. He's going to throw. He looks over the middle. He looks again. Almost intercepted. It bounced off the toe of number 25 for the Castle Knights, and that was Craig Gold. If he was back there to defend, Boudet. And Larry, that time, they had a rubber pump from Sean Welch. He pumped once. He pumped again, and then just drilled the ball into the ground, and it bounced off the foot of
That's what is called unintentional intentional grab.
Okay, I like your terminology. 11-16 to go in the ball game. We've had a fine one here, folks. 16-7, Castle leading. All formations. And they kick into the pro set. Two wide receivers. Sean West goes back. He's looking to the left. He's being chased, and he hits over the middle. So he ran out into him. Bart Denning, and Bart breaks the tackle. And he dives forward, and I think he's got enough for a first down. I tell you what, this Bart Denning is quite a versatile athlete. He is tough, and Larry, yes, we have a first down. What can you say about this Bart Denning? He is tough, Larry.
And he's all over the field. He's committed with a good athlete, going both ways.
Right, 5'10", 170-pound senior. At least the people that play with him will have to look at him again next year, but he is a good one. Okay, the quarterback I might mention for Richmond is a big boy. Sean Welch is 6'4", 190-pound senior. And he barks out the signals, I formation behind him. He goes up the middle to number 10. That might have been Sean Bart Denning again. And he picks up maybe a couple of yards to about the 30. We're going to call it the 34-yard line. Pick up the 2 second and 8. So, with 10 minutes and 20 seconds, the clock in favor right now of the Castle Knights because time is running out in the ballgame as they lead 16-7. I formation. Sean West spots out the signal. Two wide receivers. He rolls back. He goes a little drive up the middle of Corey King. He's in there. And King is still down, losing about a half a yard on the play. And let me give you again, fans, in case you're at home, this is the honest truth. Corey King is 5'3", 130-pound senior, but he's a good one. And if he gets loose, watch out.
He may be 5'2 now after that one.
All right, we have a third down, and we're going to call it 8 again because we're really not much of a loss that time. 9 minutes and 40 seconds. The clock running in favor of the Castle Knights as they lead 16-7. High formation. Two wide receivers again. Sean West rolls back, and Joe Hoff is going to kill him, and he does. Joe Hoff is in there again, and I tell you, somebody is missing a blocking assignment all night. So he is killed. Sean West, as he gets up to his knees, he's holding his back about 3, maybe 4 times, and missed him a couple of times. And again, man, John Welch, all the way back to the 51-yard line. A loss of about 12 that time, and now setting up a fourth down and about 20, a little over 20 for Richmond, and back to punt. Of course, number 10, Bart Denning, he gets off a very nice punt coming down the 44-yard line. Kenny Brown has it. He turns the right corner, and he gets back up over midfield down into Richmond territory at the 39-yard line.
35-yard punt that time, but Tom, want to go back to the preceding play where Hatch got to the quarterback. You said somebody's missing the blocking this time, but it's, that is right. He came in unmolested from his end position. Really tough feed the quarterback was.
And it looks like after this happening four or five times, it eventually be picked up, but he has been in there at least four, maybe five times. If you see the films, eventually you'll know. But I mean, there's nobody coming in, and he has a clear shot at the back of the quarterback. Okay, we'll have Mike Davis with number 36 frozen in motion. He gives to Neil Chapman up the middle, and Neil hasn't played the ball for a while, and boy, he keeps fighting forward down across the 45 to the near the 40-yard line. Neil Chapman that time on a beautiful carry up the middle, 5'9", 175 pounds senior, solidly built, and that time he picked up 7 yards down to the Richmond 41-yard line.
Tackle 16, Richmond 7, and we're going to remind you that all the scores will be coming your way on our football scoreboard at 10 this evening for Automotive Parts Supply.
So, our formation, Mike Davis turns. He gives the ball up to David Roseman. He's got enough for the first down. As he crosses the 30 down to the 35 and on beyond the 35 to the 34-yard line. Dave Roseman, the fine senior halfback who has 22 touchdowns on the year, over 1,000 yards on the ground, averaging over 6 yards, almost 7 yards a carry. First and 10 for the Castle Knights at the Richmond 34-yard line. 7:29, the clock in favor of the Castle Knights. Mike Davis rolls back. He's got the draw to Chris Roseman. Dave Roseman. Dave picks up maybe a yard down close to about the 33-yard line. That time to draw. Quarterback Mike Davis on the draw. What you do, you roll back and raise the football up, make it look like a pass. You take the football, drop it down, stick it into the halfback or fullback's stomach. He's just standing there looking like a blocker. Then he takes the ball straight up the middle, trying to pick up the yardage. Because what happens usually, Larry, the defense stands out as they come in, and that leaves the middle wide open.
Thank you, Coach Webb.
Okay, here's our formation. That is to the left. Mike Davis starts out the signal. He takes again. He gets the ball to Chris Grossman. And he breaks two tackles. He can go. He's 10, to the 9, and he's got out of bounds. A beautiful job that time. The play is set up time and time again by Mike Davis, as he does a heck of a job faking the ball. And when he finally gave it to Chris Grossman, just spun and broke a couple of tackles low and was dragged down finally to 9 yard line. He is cut.
He faked the ball to Dave going one way, then gave it to Chris cutting back against the grain the other way, and then he just did the rest on his own.
Exactly right. 9 yard line, first and goal to go for the Castle Knights. And here's where they need to get in and ice this game. Okay, Mike Davis turns. He gets the ball off to Chapman, and he gets down to about the 7, and he's still going down to the 4-yard line.
Right down.
And they have a flag on him. That's not what you need now, because that's what stopped him. Last time they had a beautiful shot at scoring from the 7-yard line and couldn't get him in because of penalties and mistakes. It looks like it's again the same thing. And if this is a 15-yarder, it's really going to hurt, and it probably is whenever it's thrown this late.
And judging from where the flag was thrown, I bet you're going to get a hold.
Right, and it's, they're talking to Tim Cornett, and of course, he's not going to decline the penalty. He's going to take it, and it's been marked 5, 10, 15, all the way back to the 24-yard line, holding on the Castle Knights. So, boy, the penalties have really made the difference. Larry, what do we have in that?
Yeah, that's now 75 yards and, no, I'm sorry, 60 yards in penalties now against the Castle Knights, 20 yards in penalties against the Richmond Red Devils.
Okay, our formation, right receiver to left. Mike Evans backs out the signal. He's in a passing situation, and he's going to throw. He's looking. Now he's going to run. He's to the 15-yard line and out of bounds, and we'll have a flag. And now that's going to put the ball down to the 7.5-yard line.
It's going to be a late hit.
Yeah.
Quarterback out of bounds and down.
And on the pulled out runway there, Larry. So I'm sure that the official was trying to protect the quarterback there, because as he went down, the tackle took him into the runway, and that's where the penalty occurred. So down the ball is going to go down to the 7.5-yard line, where it's going to be second and goal to go from the 7.5, I believe, right?
And it was little out. Three flags went down that time, and they all went down to find the penalty.
Okay, so that gets them up to 35 yards penalty. And they're marking it down. It's going to go to the 7.5-yard line. Boy, those guys are smart. They look right. This is exactly what we call out. I tell you.
They got the radio.
They got a radio.
Yeah.
Oh, I see. They got headphones on them. Those people are smart. Okay, 6:27 to go. Fans at home, don't change pitching for us. 6:27 to go here in the ball game. Castle leading the Richmond Red Devils 16-7. A beautiful night of football here at Paradise. Mike Davis has Chris Grosner in motion to the left. He turns, he goes out to double goal. Davis down across the five, down to about the 3-yard line. It's going to set up a second, a third, and goal to go from the back. The 3-yard line. The clock running in favor of the Castle Knights. And number 74 comes into the ball game. Tim Miller for Richmond, 6'5", 260 pounds. Junior. Boy, they're going to have some beef coming back next year. They'll have any backs coming back with all those guys. They're going to be setting up. Mike Davis starts out the signals. They're setting up a touchdown. Chris Grosman makes it to the left. They give off to Billy Davis. And he is in for the score. Touchdown number 23 this year for David Grosman, the fine senior back. Takes it in with 5:42 to go in the ballgame. And the score is now Castle 22 and Richmond 7. And the drive for extra point by Matt McDowell is coming up. So, a real nice sustained drive that time. Catch by quarterback Mike Davis on the shooter, taking the ball down to the 15-yard line. A penalty for a late hit, taking the ball to the 7.5. He plays off right, left tackle with perfect motion. The ball given off to Brother Dave, and he's in for the touchdown. Kenny Brown will hold back at the 15-yard line, and the kick is up, and the kick is hit by Matt McDowell. The score is now with 5:42 to go in the ball game. Castle 23, Richmond 7. We shall return.
Oh no, there goes my transmission again. The guy just fixed it a few months ago. Now he'll probably charge me again. I'm the joke of the highway. Hey, that's not funny. I can't afford this. Maybe I should just junk my car and run away to some exotic island where there are no cars. I can join a boom culture. Then I can cast the spell on that guy who fixes my transmission.
Don't drive yourself crazy. Drive yourself over to AMCO Transmissions. Choose our car ownership warranty, available on most cars, and you'll never spend another dime on your transmission. AMCO will service it free for as long as you own your car, and even provide free annual checkups as part of the warranty. See us for details and other services. AMCO. Why go anywhere else?
See your local AMCO dealer in Evansville, located at 1709 North Ferns Avenue. That's old Highway 41 North.
Okay, here we are, going into the last portion of the ball game. Only 5:32 to go in the game. And Matt McGraw kicks off, but the ball goes out of bounds. The 30-yard line automatically comes back to the 40-yard line, where it'll be first and 10 for the Richmond Red Devils. So, Larry, really, that's of no benefit that I can see right now. It's not going to affect either team. It does give Richmond good field position, but it keeps the ball away from the two scrap backs in Bart Denning and Corey King. So, nothing wrong there at all. So here we go with 5:42, and now the wind is blowing briskly as the flag is really whipping around on the north end of the football field. Sean West parks out the signal. He pitches back to Park Denny. It's going to be the halfback pass. He's trying to find somebody to throw to, and he drills it out of bounds. Almost hits the players on the sideline across the side of the field at about the 45-yard line. And he's standing there for the Castle Knights, number 66. Dan Freeman was the closest man to the exception of the football, but he was only a bystander at the time.
Well, Rod Lido had a pretty good shot.
Lido had a good shot out, Jerry. He was there at the same time. But the ball was incomplete, and Bart Denning, as a smart football player he was, the receiver was stripped of teams, he was threw it out of bounds. Okay, here we go. Sean West, close-up formation. Roger Seward on both sides. He gives the ball up to Bart Denning, and he goes up the middle. He breaks tackles. He was tough. He picks up about 8 yards on the carry. Awful close to midfield. The ball resting at the 48-yard line. Richmond turned 48. Larry, I think that young man could play somewhere on any football team in the state of Indiana. He is tough.
He is extremely tough. He's got some good moves from, as the coaches like to term it, he's got quick feet.
Right, and he hits and he gives a leg and he spins, and he's being pursued by one of the best defenses in the state of Indiana. Okay, Bart Denning takes the ball straight up the middle and says, you have the first down. You bet across midfield to about the 49-yard line. This is called timeout. 4:58 to go in the game. And it's another first down for Richmond. And how many is that, Larry?
That in the ball game now is, make it 12 now for Richmond.
12 first downs for the Richmond Red Devils. And they've been pretty well balanced, haven't they?
5 rushing and 7 passing.
Okay, yeah, not bad at all. They're a fine football team, and they've really showed that they deserve the 9-1 season they've had. Losing only to number 1 ranked Lafayette. Okay, here we go. Sean Welsh rolls back. He's going to look deep, and it's going to be overthrown. And there's a bumping situation out there, and covering for the Catholic Knights was Dave Bozeman. And he was bumping out there with the 29. Darren Cox of Richmond, 5'9", 155-pound senior spitting. It looked like a bump-and-go contest down there, Larry. The ball was overthrown. Cox did break for it for a second, like he might get to it, but it was just too far out of his reach. There we go, second and 10. The ball resting at the Castle 49-yard line. Sean West starts out the signals. He pitches back to his little halfback, Corey King. He is going to be nailed and drilled down. And right there for the Castle Knights is number 67, Rick Van Heath. 6 foot, 210-pound senior defensive tackle, and he didn't look too good anyway.
And now a timeout for the Richmond Red Devils with 4:34 left in the ballgame. Castle leading 23 to 7.
Here's Linda from Image Consultants.
Hey, little head. Maybe it's because you can't get it to curl or shine. I'm dreaming of a phone that's gone wild, a color that's gone wrong. Or could it be you're stuck with a cat you detest? Don't feel stranded. Call the Grand Hair Repair, Image Consultants. East 476-1190 or north at 423-5746.
Or call their newest location in the Newburgh Plaza South. 853-0402. Image Consultants for the great hair repair. Car insurance, homeowners insurance, life insurance, health insurance. Four good reasons to choose State Farm. Four good reasons to see State Farm agent Jim Fanning. After all, State Farm is the largest car insurance, the leading homeowners insurance, and one of the fastest growing life insurances. State Farm offers economical insurance protection plus prompt personal service. See State Farm agent Jim Fanning in the Newburgh Plaza.
Okay, here's a pass right over the middle, and that's going to be complete to number 22, and it's going to be enough for a first down. Randy Gibson taking that pass. It was drilled in by quarterback Sean West, and good enough for a first down on a third and 12 all the way down to the 34-yard line of Castle. This Sean West shows that he has an arm there, as he is being encompassed by about 5 tacklers from the Knights, and he held right in there and drilled that ball into Randy Gibson. A real nice completion that time. Big quarterback, 6'4", 190-pound senior Sean West. So 4:10 in the clock running against the Richmond Red Devils, 8-4, 22-7. West is back to pass. He throws out in the right side, and it is complete to one of his big split ends, number 86, Scott Bell, 6'1", 190-pound. And he is out of bounds at a 15-5, 30-yard line of the Castle Knights. A pickup of about 5 on the carry, or on the completion. Sets up a second and 5. So 4 minutes and 1 second to go in the ball game. Castle leading here at Paradise 23-7 over a real fine Richmond Red Devil football team.
Castle defense bending and bending, but never breaking. So here we go. Sean Welsh, quarterback, our formation, two wide receivers, he rolls back, he's looking. He pumps again, he's got a man open, but it's going to be out of bounds, and it is. Incomplete as he tried to hit. Let's see who it was down there at about the 5-yard line. It was number 86, and again, that was Scott Bell that went down the right sideline, and Bell was overthrown at about the 5-yard line. So now that sets up the third and five with 3 minutes and 55 seconds to go in the ball game. Castle leading 23-7. And remember, fans, they have not given up more than 7 points in any game this year. But the number that you give up makes no difference as long as you have more than the other team. Here we go. One back is all Sean Welsh has back, so he's going to throw the ball. He's been pursued, and he is still down for a loss of about 10 yards on that play. And there to wrap him up is number 62, Rodney Russell, 6'190" senior. And now timeout by a very frustrated Richmond Red Devil team. Larry, that time when Sean Welsh rolled back his feet, went out from underneath, and he tried to keep his balance when he turned around. He got killed.
Well, it was a brother of the Castle by played by Russell, who decked him for a 10-yard loss. And it's going to set up now a 4th-and-13 situation. Another group of our tournament boosters, Newberg Business Service, of H&R Block of Newberg, the Perigo Funeral Home, Newberg House of Furniture, Custom Furniture and Uncustomary Prices, and Pizza Chef and the Newberg Plaza. We do want to remind you, complete Election 82 coverage coming up here this evening, following the ballgame on WDML. And remember, our prep football scoreboard for automotive parts supply at 10 o'clock. James will have all of the scores in the matchup from Sectional play throughout the state of Indiana.
Okay, here come the Richmond Red Devils with 3:33 to go in the ballgame. Trying to get themselves close to the Castle Knights as they trail 23-7. Castle on top here with only 3:33 to go in the ballgame.
They're going for it out of 4th and 13.
That's the only thing they can do. I formation, two wide receivers. Sean Welsh rolls back. He stops. He drills it out in the flat. It's complete. And it's going to be enough for the first down. I think he ran in the wrong direction. That's going to be close, though. I think he does have it, but he took a step backwards and was hit. But I think he made it as he's down at about the 24-yard line. It's going to be real close. The receiver that time is number 85, Lloyd Spicer, 6'164" senior. And they're going to measure it, Larry, and I would say he has the first down by inches. And they're getting ready to mark it. Oh! Short and Larry, can you tell him now? It looks like a 2 or 3 inches. So the Castle Knight teams, you can hear them in the background. And the team comes off the field. They're congratulated by the coaches as again they have not broke the beat, and they left Richmond move down to the 24-yard line, but it wasn't enough for a first down. So now the Knights will do the thing that they need to, and that's keep the ball on the ground, run the clock out. And this is going to be another step forward for the Castle Knights as they're going to go to 11-0 on the season. High formation. Mike Davis gives off the fullback straight up the middle, and I believe it was number 22. It was Neil Chapman, and Chapman picks up about 3 yards on the field, but he really cares as the clock runs, and that's the important thing. 3 minutes to go in the game. A pickup of 3 yards, 2nd and 7 for the Castle Knights.
And Tom, we'll be getting that score out of Martinsville coming up right at the end of this ball game. Their ball game with Columbus East. And if Martinsville has won and Castle wins, we'll be at Martinsville on Saturday night.
Oh, Bill Siderwick is going to want to get even after getting shellacked 35-0 last year when he was rushing too far ahead and forgot about the Castle Knights. Okay, here's a good straight up the middle, and it looks like it might have been number 28, Chris Grosner, or Dave Grosner on the carry. Let's see who it was. No, it was number 30, Chris Grosner on the carry. And Chris picked up very good yardage, about 5 on the carry, and it's going to leave 3rd and a long one. We're going to call it 3rd and long one, but more important than that game, the clock is down to 2 minutes and 5 seconds to go in the game. Chris Grosner comes off the field for a little rest. Chris Grosner brothers, his entire backfield, Mike Davis with his tremendous coaching. They are some kind of football team. 3rd and the long one, our formation. Here's the give inside, and yes, he easily has a first down as he drags himself up the middle over the
35-yard line, and that's none other than number 22, Neil Chapman. The ball now resting at the 39-yard line. Another first down. How many is that, Larry?
That's for the Castle Knights back. 18 in the ball game.
So 18 first downs for the Castle Knights. That shows the offensive power that they have. And here comes the offensive center up for the Castle Knights, and that's Pat Lockyer. He sets his team. I formation. Mike Davis parks out the signals. He gives off to number 23 that time for the Castle Knights, and that's Joe Dillman. Joe Dillman is 5'7", 140-pound senior, and Joe picks up about 2 tough yards right up the gut. Crosses the 40 down to the 41-yard line. But more important than that, the clock runs down to 1 minute and 10 seconds to go in the game. And it's over, game. It's going to be over. Castle Knights are going to win 22-7. And they're going to go to the regional round Saturday night, probably at Martinsville. And where is our Artesians be waiting? Okay, here we go. And there's a give again to Dillman right up the middle. He picks up maybe a yard. And I think this time Richmond is going to call timeout. And with 39 seconds to go in the ball game, and Richmond calling timeout to score, Castle 23, Richmond 7, and we have timeout here. We'll be back in 1 minute.
Bill Riney's Newburgh Pharmacy is much more than a retail store. It's a community institution which serves the community of Newburgh and surrounding area in many important ways. People feel secure in the knowledge that this fine drugstore is always available when needed, with complete stocks of drugs, medicines, gift ideas, even those seldom required. It's a new advantage to avail yourself of the many services offered by Bill Riney's Newburgh Pharmacy at 333 State Street in Newburgh. The finest prescription service you could ask for, along with complete stocks of all the quality merchandise you expect to find in a modern drugstore. And where reasonable prices and consistent values pay your dividends in time, quality, and money. There's extra satisfaction waiting you at Bill Riney's Newburgh Pharmacy, 333 State Street in Newburgh.
And we're finally in the Martinsville school. It's Martinsville 35, Columbus East, nothing. Now back to Larry.
Okay, here we go with a good straight up the middle. It looks like it's carried. I'm not sure exactly who it was. I think we'll see here in a minute. It was Castle Knights are running some new players. And it was carried by number 33 of the Castle Knights, Scott Thurman, a fullback, 6'7", 180-pound sophomore. And he picked up about halfway close to a first down. Larry?
You're going to get a pretty good roar here, I imagine. And they get the score from Martinsville.
Martinsville 35. Okay, I tell you, the Castle fans just as well get ready, because the team they saw last year, I'm sure Tyler Whitman, the type of guy, he doesn't forget, and he'll come after you with anything he can do, and those Artesian fans are wild. Okay, here we go, 4th and 1. There's a good and a beautiful second effort by none other than Neil Chapman, and he got down to about midfield, and that's going to be enough for a first down, and that's going to be enough to end the ball game with 12 seconds to go. And there's no doubt in my mind, I think they're all going to measure just for the courtesy of measuring. But regardless of if there is or is not a first down, there, there's only 12 seconds to go in the game with Castle leading 23-7.
And the Castle Knights will be at Martinsville Saturday night in a regional play, and we will be on the air with our pregame show. And I would assume that they have a starting time of 7:30 up there, which would be 6:30 our time, and that would put our pregame show time at 6:05.
Okay, and that's another first down for the Knights, and I believe that's about 19 in the game. Here the fans carrying off the time. That's the end of the ball game with the Castle Knights defeating a fine Richmond Red Devils football team, 22-7. Castle goes 11-0 on the year. Richmond now at 9-2 on the year. What a fine football game we have here. And we shall return, Liz.
Okay, we'll be back with a look at all of the wrap-up in the score. And the final score, Castle 23, Richmond 7.
Automotive Supply on State Road 66, 1 mile east of the 261 junction near Newburgh, features quality NAPA brand replacement parts for both domestic and foreign-built cars and trucks, farm equipment, and industrial equipment. Keep in mind that Warwick Automotive Supply is the do-it-yourselfer's best friend. Open Monday through Friday, 7 to 7, Saturday, 8 to 5, Warwick Automotive Supply on State Road 66, 1 mile east of the 261 junction near Newburgh.
For the finest selection of manufactured housing, plus modular homes, double wides, and many, many standard-sized mobile homes, visit Mobile Manor Manufactured Home Sales, featuring such well-known and respected brand names as Donna Bell, Broadmoor, and Nashua, both new and used. Mobile Manor Manufactured Home Sales can help you with selecting that home you've always wanted. Plus, there's service after the sale, complete delivery and setup, and much, much more. And if location is a problem, Mobile Manor Manufactured Home Sales has plenty of park spaces available, serving the entire tri-state area of southern Indiana, southern Illinois, and western Kentucky. Mobile Manor Manufactured Home Sales, State Road 62, east of Chandler, a division of Eastside Mobile Homes, Newburgh.
Do you have broken glass problems with your car or home? Let the experts at Sealant Glass Company, 1011 Vine Street in Evansville, help you. Sealant Glass will replace your broken windshields on your car or truck, and they offer pickup and delivery service, commercial or residential. They also have mobile service for glass replacement for your home, including storm doors, windows, sliding back glass, and desk and tabletops. Call 422-4149 for one-day service in most cases. Now's the time to check for broken glass around the home before winter sets in. Zenith Glass Company, 1011 Vine Street, Evansville, serving the tri-state since 1943.
Tired of waiting forever to have your prescription filled? You need never worry at the Plaza Pharmacy in the Newburgh Plaza Shopping Center, because they have two registered pharmacists ready to assist you whenever you need them, Ken Hacker and Don Bebald. The friendly pharmacists at the Plaza Pharmacy are available to fill your health needs quickly and efficiently, Monday through Friday from 9 a.m. to 9 p.m., and on Sundays from 12 noon to 5 p.m. And the Plaza Pharmacy also provides 24-hour emergency prescription service and free prescription delivery throughout the Newburgh, Chandler, and Boonville areas. So if service is what you're seeking, try the service people at the Plaza Pharmacy, Highway 261 north of Newburgh in the Newburgh Plaza Shopping Center.
Okay, well, right back here, Lloyd, I might point out that the festivities after the game, Mr. Ed Rover, principal at the Country High School, and in case you didn't know that, I tell you, I was fortunate enough to become assistant principal at the Country this year, and I really enjoyed working with Mr. Rover. Ed Rover, being the principal at the Country, is also the chairman of the board of directors for the ISSAA, and he passed out the football to the runner-up team tonight, which was the West Richmond Red Devils, and that went to none other than Bart Denny. And what a fine, gracious young man he was as he came here and took the football and was congratulated by a host throughout the night. Finally, the championship trophy for the Sectional was given to the Castle Knights, and of course, that was Mike Davis and Rodney Russell, the co-captains tonight, along with the entire team, who did such a fantastic job receiving the championship trophy here at Paradise tonight for Mr. Ed Rosen of the ISSAA. So, Larry, now it's set.
Okay, Castle 23, Richmond 7, as we take a look at the second half scoring. Each ball club was failed in their first offensive series to do anything. Richmond opened the second half receiving the kickoff. They moved the ball 16 yards before they had to pump the ball away 34 yards with 8:25 left in the third quarter. The Castle Knights took it over, and in two plays, they have lost 12 yards. And then Bart Benning intercepted on the third play from the line of scrimmage, ran the ball back to the Castle 44-yard line, where with 7 minutes left in the third quarter, the Richmond Red Devils set up shop. But they could not pick up the first down, and they had to punt the ball away. Each ball club punted. And on the next possession by the Richmond Red Devils, they had the ball intercepted by Pat Lockyer. The Castle Knights drove the ball down to the Richmond 9. That set up a field goal attempt by Matt McDowell, and his attempt, 26 yards, was wide to the right. That brought the ball, and that, by the way, closed out the third quarter. It brought the ball to the Richmond 20-yard line, and the Richmond Red Devils could do nothing, picked up a first down, gaining a total of 1 yard as they picked up about 16 yards, but then had a 15-yard penalty. Punted the ball away 35 yards,
where Castle set up shop with 8:50 remaining on the Richmond 39-yard line. 9 plays and 39 yards later, a four-yard run in by Dave Brosner for the touchdown. The kick by Matt McDowell was good, and with 5 minutes and 32 seconds left on the clock, the Castle Knights have run the score out to 23-7. That set up the last pitch heroic by the Richmond Red Devils, and they could not convert on a first down situation with 3:32 left. Turned the ball over to the Castle Knights on downs, and the Castle Knights picked up a couple of first downs, ran out the last 3 minutes and 32 seconds on the clock to claim their 11th victory on the season. Again, Castle 23 and Richmond 7. I'll be back with a look at the total game of team statistics following these messages.
Everywhere you turn today, you can make aliens a creepy man to capture and control $9 million. That's why you need a sound strategy, sturdy advice, and a strong financial partner. So come to World National Bank, where you can map out a sound financial strategy with a strong financial partner.